name of the game. Defusal on PL and Morphling. It's, do you go shotgun or Morphling, or are you going for more of a right click build?
You're probably gonna need Manta this game against the chains, and possibly to juke the Doom a bit.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm not sure. I feel like he can probably go for either.
Yeah, Lincoln's into Batrider and Dooms feels maybe important, but then they've also got a lot to defend the Morphlings, so maybe not.
I mean, Lincoln's is really good. I also like Lincoln's. Because they don't really have a way to break it, really.
Yeah. Alrighty, let's go. Game number two, JStorm versus Virtus Pro is now coming up, and we're going to be able to see whether the American boys can even things out or whether it's going to be a 2-0 for the CIS squad of Virtus Pro. I think judging from these drafts, I'm a little bit JStorm favored for this one. I gotta say, I feel like Virtus Pro are a little bit too slow for my liking, considering how last game went. JStorm do not want to be giving them the space. I think Alchemist is gonna have a nice time, and then it's just gonna be a running down lanes from JStorm from there on out. What do you think?
I agree. I feel like, I'm not sure about the supports of JStorm, but other than that, I like the Alch pick a lot. So, rooting for my NA boys. This game is also gonna depend on what neutral item drops. Is if, for example, Radiant get the trusty shovel, I'm pretty sure they're almost winning the game for sure.
Wow, that's a big claim, but of course, if you have the chance of finding those bounty runes and you've got an alchemist on your team, then that ain't balanced. Do you think that needs to be changed? Maybe the bounty runes don't give bonuses for Alk, or are they just gonna leave it?
I'm not sure. It's really hard to balance these neutral items. For example, That's why they removed a lot of them. For example, the Tome of Aghanims. It's like extremely good on some heroes, like for example Zeus. It basically wins you the game.
Insane.
And on some heroes it's absolutely useless. And there's no way to balance this. So they just removed it.
Yeah, it's fair enough. Like Alchemist it was absolutely useless on. But yeah, Zeus it was disgusting on. I think that's the same with the helmet on dying as well, you know. And Huskar, give him a helmet for the end dying, and he just became completely unstoppable because he would just die of your fountain, and then even though he dies after killing two of you, he then kills the other three of you whilst he's already dead.
The Helm of Undying, the thing about that is that it basically breaks the way you want to play Dota. Like, in a lot of cases, you want to try to kill one hero and go from there. For example, like, focus down Warlock or Enigma.
Exactly.
But with this item, you cannot do that. There's literally nothing you can do about it.
Yeah, that Warlock is going to drop his ulti. Also, it was buggy as hell. it's worth noting that item was bugged out beyond recognition. You could hand it to your other players so that if you died, you could just pass it on to someone else and then they could have the Helm of Undying and they would die and come back to life. You could kill Meepo twice with it, which obviously means you didn't want to have it on Meepo, but if the main Meepo died and then you could still kill his like side Meepos and get two kills onto the Meepo in one. I won a game like that against a Meepo booster. It was glorious.
Alright, so the bounties are 2-for-2, and so far, Radiant are winning with Lassets.
Yeah, they're doing alright, off to a pretty good start. Kind of what we expected, they've got these really strong side laning heroes, and they've got the very greedy picks on the side off of Virtus Pro in the Morphling and the Phantom Lancer, who, they're not bad laners for greedy heroes, but they're definitely not going to be putting out a ton of pressure. I mean, what up in the top lane, they're just gathering around Brax here, but Brax doesn't really care. In fact, it's Resolution who might be in some trouble as a tag team comes out from Moose and the hit's coming through, especially with the creeps as well, helping out Resolution in some trouble. They're on top of him. They've got the snowball. They've got the right clicks and they'll get the kill. Resolution is dropped. And that's going to be your first blood.
That was really impressive from Moose because I wasn't watching, but I feel like Moose was the one who pulled the creep wave. So he basically pulled the creep wave on small camp and then he dived Resolution. Wow.
Yeah, that's a heads-up play. That is absolutely knowing your limits, knowing your timings, and then manipulating the game to make sure you can take full advantage of them. Very nice indeed. So, Resolution taking an early death. Meanwhile, down in the bottom lane, Save and Solo battling it up with Mu. Mu, he's probably the slowest starting hero on this JStorm side. No big surprise, they have trail in against him, so they're trying to make his Alchemist suffer as much as they can. But in response, killing this Beastmaster, that's the thing, like, Alchemist doesn't need to have a great lane. If everybody else has a great lane and the Alchemist doesn't, then you've still won two out of three lanes, and you know that this Alchemist is going to go farm the jungle. And Resolution, he's going to be going down again here, I think. I mean, they still got the snowball, they throw it out, and that's going to be another kill up in the top lane. Resolution dying twice, and there's action at bottom, moves in trouble. Epileptic Kid is going to be able to finish him off. The Tusk, he's coming over, but I'm not really sure there's much he can do. He's still got his cooldowns from the little fight at top, so they will have to waste, but Moose might have snuck in here, even though there's a Observer Ward. I think he's just about out of vision. Let's see if they can make anything happen here.
They saw him before when he DP'd.
Yeah, okay.
But I really liked what Chase Storm did. So they basically killed the beast twice, so he cannot TP there. So at this point, Doom has a really big advantage over him.
Yeah.
So he should be able to win this lane without any issues. And now they're tri-laning, but
yep,
which should be fine. It helps though.
Yeah, I like this build from Brax as well, going for the 2 points of Scorched Earth and one of Infernal Blade as well, just to be able to put as much pressure onto this Beastmaster as possible, while still being able to get a lot with the Devour and any auras which happen to pop up as well. Meanwhile, let's have a look over towards this mid lane, because it is an interesting one. No one on the Morphling versus 9 on the Ember Spirit, and both of them which are at 0 HP, but unfortunately for 9, he's going to have to go back to base, and no one does not, so bit of an advantage starting out for this Morphling. 22 and 12 right now compared to the Ember Spirit's pitiful 13 and 4.
Yeah, that's probably another reason why they decided to go for Morph, because no one was confident in winning this matchup.
Yeah, a bit of an unusual one, but no one certainly knew it. Very experienced player. And they're kind of trading hits down here in the bottom lane. Solo and Save gonna come in, actually looking towards Moose here. The Ryclex coming through onto him, but he's a pretty tanky boy. They are unable to find the correct target though, as they try to go for the wrong illusions. Electric Kid just being very, very annoying on this Phantom Lancer, playing them a little bit here. Is there any way to reliably select the tanky illusion whenever you do use Doppelganger?
Like as a PL?
Yeah.
Yeah,
there's a fight breaking out right now as Moo's actually getting the target. Moo's just trying to zone out Solo. Solo is able to take out the bounty room, but it looks like Moo will be falling here. Can they get a revenge kill? Well, 9's coming in. They need to find something here, but actually Epileptic is just going for the TP out. Nothing to stop that save. Gonna follow suit. Solo will not be as lucky. He's gonna be finished off, but still, only one kill for a rotation from 9 and onto a Crystal Maiden. Certainly not what they were looking for with that one. So 9 gonna have to return to lane a little bit disappointed.
They got how many? They got 3 bounties on VP.
Yeah, against an Alchemist as well.
That's really well played by Virtus Pro, by dodging the rotation.
Yep, just realizing that there's no stuns, TPing themselves out ASAP, and that's going to put an end to it. And I imagine that's the point where they just ask towards mid lane, hey, does he have chains? And no one's like, nah, buddy, doesn't have chains. Sweet. That's a freebie. Wow.
Yeah, so the way you wanna like select the tanky illusion with PL is that you have control groups, so you can like beforehand you can assign a hotkey to the tanky illusion and to the other one. Then when you use doppelganger, you just basically like press a key and then you're.
Well, that's very easy. Mofara told me that didn't work, but Mofara's a dirty liar, I guess.
Yeah, he is. I use that all the time.
Meanwhile, on top lane, we've got another kill. He is level 6, but didn't need to use it. That is just Brax destroying Resolution up here in the top. And JStorm, they've actually rotated heroes, two heroes in for this one. I'm wondering what they're expecting, and they just want to kill him again. This feels a little bit mean, kind of bullying Resolution. Now that Sticky Napalm, he realizes something is up. Moos is on top of him. There's a TP coming in from the Ruby, but I'm not sure what it's going to achieve. Although Moos is taking a lot of damage from the tower, but they're just allowing Resolution to cook to Fear here. But I'm not sure Fear's actually going to be able to finish the job. So Brax comes flying in, trying to finish it off. Fear, can he see him? Yes, he can. He needs to get the right click off. Does get it, but Resolution, he's healing, but he is going to roast.
He's not going to roast.
Resolution, the Firefly runs out, but now the Snowball comes through. Moos finally finished the job. Meanwhile, Brax kill save in the middle lane. Hello? Oh, that was a courier. Okay, no one's courier dies. Sorry, I didn't see the little courier icon. That's okay. So Moo finds himself a courier. Meanwhile, the action continues in the top lane as they're able to bring down Moo's as no one has a double damage rune and makes good use of it to kill off the Tusk. So finding another retribution kill up here in the top lane. And Brax gonna
nice
try
tricks.
And sneakily get himself away. Does get himself out of danger there. Just about. And no one, he wants a piece of Mu right now, and he's got all the damage in the world. He's just going to keep on chasing, but there's a TP in from the Tusk, and that's going to scare off the Morphling for now. But man, this guy just does not have a lane. Meanwhile, down at bottom, 9 getting beaten up by Epileptic Kid as well. 9 not safe wherever he goes. JStorm just being forced off the map currently. Only place that's safe is the top lane. And Brax is just, he's just sitting here.
I mean, the teams are basically trading heroes. That Beastmaster is having a really rough game and Alk is having a really rough game. And I feel like that's kind of fine for both teams, because Dire are happy that Alk is not farming and Radiant are happy that Beastmaster, which is the main like pushing power of Virtus Pro, is also not having that good of a game.
Yeah,
even
that's
though
true, that is.
He has a lot of levels, so he's doing fine on Reso.
Yeah, level 5. Gonna hit level 6 with a couple more creeps. Definitely not a bad place to be as a Beastmaster, despite dying a bunch of times, as you say. So, meanwhile, on top lane, there's a bit of aggression coming out from Virtus Pros. There's a lot of low health heroes up here, but not much more is gonna come of this. We'll throw it over to Net Worth and see Doom sitting pretty on that top spot. Brax. No surprise to see him right up there, but followed closely by the Morphling and then by the Phantom Lancer. Not how we were expecting this one to go. We'll see how things extend through into the mid game. If JStorm can find a bit of purchase and a bit of space for this Alchemist, they should be able to.
The issue is that Amber is having a really rough game. He has 1k less net worth than Morph. So, and this is the hero that Radiant wants to play, make plays with. The Ember wants to run around and kill people, but he can't because he's kind of behind.
Yeah, it's feeling a bit slow from JStorm. And it's a hard one as well, because they obviously want to give 9 the space to farm up, get some solo XP, but at the same time, it's not really that safe for him to farm anywhere. But now there's a smoke coming out from Virtus Pro. I feel like this was spotted by JStorm, as there was a ping here, but Brax is gonna walk straight into it. I'm not entirely sure they can kill Brax, especially if you don't roar him. Brax gets into the tree lines. That puts an end to that, I guess. Never refuse. Well, mood. Finding some of this delicious honey, the royal jelly.
All right, outposts are 1 for 1, bounties 2 for 2. Just fine for JStorm.
Yeah, for sure. They get to chill a little bit. Virtus Pro can't keep up this very high pressure they had in the laning phase. As mentioned, just a little bit slow on their cores. Need to find a couple of items first before they want to start being really active on this map. Resolution going to be the big tower defender here, just able to stand up against 2 or 3 heroes by himself. No really worries about that one.
It's interesting that Reso is going for a different build. He's not going for the HOD this game, and he opts for the Medallion. Which, I mean, HOD is not that good against Doom because he can eat your creep, but the item is still really strong. And also, he's not going for Vlad, which is also a really strong item. So this is interesting. Medallion helps you with, like, focus fire.
Ooh,
on
solo
targets.
He gets Infernal Bladed and War Stomped, and this is going to be a kill. They're going to leave it for Mu? Yeah, you bet they are. Mu's going to try and grab that one himself. And that's going to be a kill for the Alchemist now. So, again, just getting him on the board. Of course, Grievous Greed from kills, always nice. Meanwhile, down at bottom, they're looking for 9, but 9 gets a TP away. He's going to get himself to safety. I really like what he did there, even though it wasn't actually a factor. There's always a risk. Oh, he's coming back in. Hello, sir. This is not where you want to be. You're trying to dodge out the Roar here and doing a pretty good job of doing so, but now the Roar comes out. Moves his hair. He's kind of come in with the snowball, and the stun is out. Nine's actually surviving this one. Can he live? Yes, he will. It's no one who's being controlled up on the front lines by the punch as well. Virtus Pro will be able to put them to reverse now and get themselves out of this situation. JStorm unable to push the issue any further than this, but still a great little play there from Nine as he just buys himself a bunch of time, jumps around the fight, avoids a Roar, and that's gonna be it. They get everybody else in, and the fight is neutralized. Nothing happens, which I think is better for JStorm right now. And I say nothing happens, I think solo might be happening right now as they're looking for the Crystal Maiden, about to make her no longer a maiden. As well, going for the ultimate, but nope, that's not gonna happen. Tag team finishes the job. Epileptic Kid jumping in, as is no one coming in from behind. The damage coming through, trying to find 9 though, gonna get himself a remnant over to safety. jumping back he will, but there was a TP here, and it is a Rubik save, has a lift throw and back, chains are out, Zap is there, and 9 is demolished. Lotus Pro gonna find themselves the Ember Spirit, unfortunately remnanting over to a TP point when Saver's just TPing in on that. Not the greatest of ideas, but well, they get the return kill onto Resolution, but now Moose is going to drop as well to Epileptic here, but the Doom comes out onto him, and this is a dead Phantom Lancer. Brax finds it right. Is he?
Yeah, he's dead.
Yeah, he's dead, right? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a bit unfortunate by Ember with the Remnant usage, but I really like what Chase Storm did. Defending the towers and while giving Alk space is exactly what they should be doing.
Absolutely. Meanwhile, the middle lane save is getting jumped on right now. 9 looking for his revenge, and he will find it. No one's going to be a little bit cautious as well, as Fear is here with the lasso, but no one. He's pretty confident just to play up into them. There's no immediate catch, so he's always going to be able to get that strength morph off, and they don't have enough damage to burn through him if that's the case. So, yeah, we'll relax. But JStorm, they're doing a pretty good job on trying to kind of get a bit of an advantage back in this game. And now with a 2k net worth advantage, not a huge amount with an Alchemist in the game, but they're getting there. They're giving him the space as well. Making action happening where Moo is not is a very important concept when you're playing with Alchemist.
Yep. Doom also has Crimson, which is huge. That negates almost all dire damage, except for Maiden and Rubik.
Let's go, Veil Maiden. I'm ready.
Yeah, this Doom is extremely fat top.
Yeah, this Crimson Time is going to be huge for them being able to fight as well. Now they're looking towards the Beastmaster as well. Beastmaster is getting chained up, punched up, beaten down. He's going to throw out the Roar for what, though? It's just going to buy him a couple more seconds of life, but notable death. And JStorm, again, you know, finding the aggression, finding the players, going for the smoke. They might be behind, but they're not really beaten down. And Virtus Pro, well, they're going for a rotation of their own here. Save leading the charge, looking to cut them off up in the top lane. There are 4 JStorm heroes here, so it's not the easiest pick-off in the world. What are they looking for? Maybe wait and see if someone comes back. Maybe go looking for the bounty runes. Yeah, it seems to be a bounty room play here. Meanwhile, Epileptic Kid and Brax getting busy with each other. No one. Rezo. They're all meeting up. JStorm are now a little bit outnumbered. Moo, did he see the Hawk? He certainly did not, because it was under the cover of Invis. They had no sentry down. Moo's now in a really bad place, and I don't think he's getting out of this one. Look at the damage coming out of the Morphling. They're going to be able to bring him down. That is an Alchemist put to death here in the top. Unfortunately, the rest of JStorm will just run themselves away, but he did actually finish off that Radiance just before he died there, so not really losing much for his death, I don't think.
Yeah, but yeah, still, huge pick-off by Virtus Pro.
And Virtus Pro, they are still hanging around here, but now the Brax shows up, he's a big boy, he's a scary one. They can't really fight into him so well, but meanwhile there's a lasso coming out, and that's going to be able to take care of Fear. They look forward for more now. This is going to be a, well, looks like it might be a good fight, although I say that save just absolutely melts, and it doesn't look like Epileptic Kid's having a particularly good time either. That's going to be a second kill coming down. Unable to get the damage off, they'll look for the Doom, but they cancel it out. Meanwhile, the Roar comes out onto Ember Spirit. Ember Spirit's in a lot of trouble right now, but trying to get himself away, but that Remnant is so very slow, and the right click will follow him. No one brings him down. It's a triple kill for him. There's a big mistake coming out from JStorm as they lose their Alchemist twice in quick succession. He might have finished off that Radiance, but you still can't afford to be losing your Alchemist quite like this. He needs to be finding gold. He needs to be finding the win condition for your team.
Yeah, I don't know. This felt like bot.
Yeah, this is Resolution. Maybe going to be responded upon here, but no one finishes off the shotgun and fires it off into Fear's face, and Moo's going to be headed the same way as well. Can they track him down? There's another hero coming in. Unfortunately, it is Solo here to cut off the Tusk's retreat. No one is just rampaging through this game right now. He is in control.
Yeah, perfect rotation by... reaction by Virtus Pro. The last fight, I don't know, it felt like it should have been really good because they just hit their timing. They have Radiance, they have Crimson, they should be really strong, but for some reason they just got overwhelmed anyways. No one is zoning with the C-Blade, which yeah. I don't think he had, but still. Strong boy.
Strong watery boy taking control of this game, dissolving the side of JStorm. You see, what's wrong here is they've picked Ember Spirit and Doom, you know, very fiery heroes, and Morphlings are water-based heroes, so naturally.
Oh, true.
That could have been what Dota became. I mean, they tried it. About last year or so, they tried it for about 2 weeks. We had elemental damage. That was fun.
Yeah.
Ember Spirit jumping away once again, nearly getting lifted and roared. Playing a dangerous game, and Moose and Brax are under the vision of this Hawk, allowing Resolution to easily escape. Always on the point with these Hawks just to catch out J-Storm. I don't think they've been doing a great job in getting rid of these Hawks either. You know, the vision's always been there, and they're just like that. They pick up another one. Fear was not safe. He thought he could play around the tree line, but there was a little birdie staring at him the entire time. Moose again being caught out by these Hawks time and time again. They are just abusing the vision that Rezo has given them.
Radiant heroes are dying left and right. Sizzard Brax.
Oh god, and Sentinel as well. Doom's gonna go down, sending no one godlike Brax. This is your Doom. This is your big tanky hero. This is the guy who J-Storm was supposed to be playing around, and he just gets popped like a balloon.
What's happening? I mean,
no one's happening, baby. He's taking this game in control. He's even found himself a little growth bow here, or as I like to call it, the groove bow. And he is certainly in the groove. He's reducing magical resistance of the attacked enemy by 12% and attack range in combination with the Ethereal Blade. That sounds pretty sick to me.
Yeah.
All right, Rezo dies. We got something here. J-Storm, they're scraping the bottom of the barrel, and they find Resolution there.
I just noticed that Rezo is 0-8.
Is he actually?
Latino? Yeah.
Yeah.
He's providing auras for his team, so.
Providing auras and hawks. Exactly. Auras and hawks, baby. That's all you need. Essence ring now found by Virtus Pro. I don't know who you give that to.
Dire have a really good ward at the shrine. I'm surprised that J-Storm didn't deward then.
Yeah, these cliff wards are so disgusting. Like, you have to get rid of them. Honestly, in general, I feel like J-Storm just need sentries on the ground. You know, they need to get rid of these Hawks. They're just doing so much for the side of Virtus Pro, but of course, hard for... I mean, they'll know that these Hawks are... Oh, look, there's a Hawk causing trouble for Moose once again, trying to fight up into the PL. Lepetica, though, he's locked down. No, they're going for the bait! They're going for the illusion once again. Fear, Moose, dropping like flies. Brax going to be heading the same way as well. The Crimson Guard doing a bit to help him survive a little bit here. The Doom comes out onto no one, so at the very least, he's not going to be killing him instantly. But, I mean, Brax is just going to be slowly, slowly, slowly picked away. While Step Electric Kid goes for the long chase, finds the Ember Spirit. That's four heroes dead. Hello, Roshan. You're looking mighty fine today. What's a pretty scaly beast doing in a pit like this? Virtus Pro will take him home.
This was the moment that they could have won the game, or like get into a really good position if they just went for the right PL there, but Epileptic gets outplaying them.
Every time, man. Every goddamn time. Epileptic Kid and his Phantom Lancer. You cannot underestimate it. Oh, it's gotta feel bad for J-Storm though. They had him. Dead to rights. If you just go on the right target, or even if they split it 50-50, I reckon they would have brought him down. He was such a vulnerable target right then, but unfortunately they all chased the wrong illusion, and Epileptic Kid gets himself to safety. Unreal.
Well, yeah, that was impressive.
Virtus Pro are very much in the driving seat. In fact, they've been here for pretty much the entire game.
What does Aug have? BKB. BKB on Aug, that, I mean, helps, but I feel like they still need AC. Because he dies to the physical damage.
Yeah, the Crimson Guard is not quite cutting it just yet. Well, it's the shotgun is bad, so at least this saves them from just being immediately eliminated from the fight. And hopefully the Crimson Guard can kick in. Brax is going for the same thing as well. He wants that BKB just to save him from the shotgun potential for Morph.
Yeah, Morph has now Lincolns as well. I like this build a lot for no one. Now when I'm looking at it, he doesn't really need Manta. The E-Blade first, because he's having a really good game, is really strong. because it gives them a ton of magical damage as well as physical. And now with Lincoln's, it's also extremely hard to focus him down.
Yeah, the Crimson Guard just looks pretty pitiful now in comparison to this E-Blade. Chains come out onto the wrong target, Ember Spirit getting down to 1/3 HP. No one tries to steal the Ember Spirit form and go for the kill there. That would have been tasty. Fear, he's hanging out, but he's got a Blink Dagger, but unfortunately with this Lincoln's up, no one doesn't really care.
Dire structures are fortified.
Yeah.
Oh, no one, just zoning back moves all by himself.
I mean, the really scary thing is that they have absolutely nothing to pop the Lincolns. They have Lasso, Concoction, and Doom, which are all, or Snowball perhaps, but Snowball is really hard. They have zero items to pop the Lincolns, from what I'm seeing.
Yeah, it's becoming a very impossible task to bring down the Morphling. They need more than what they've got. They're making their ways there. Where's this BKB on the Doom? Alright, it's now finished up. They've got an Essence Ring as well. Is that their Essence Ring or the enemy Essence Ring? Okay, that's the enemy's Essence Ring. Cool.
Is it?
It is indeed, yeah.
Ooh.
Grand Theft Essence Ring. Is that enough to change the scales of the game, though?
Oh, that's the question. I don't think so.
No, you don't? Damn. Thought they had it there. Oh, well.
It feels good, though. If you steal an opponent's item, it feels really good. Especially, like, in later parts of the game.
Oh, Lasso out onto the Crystal Maiden. This is a nice target to be able to bring down, and they will be able to do so. All right, solo. She's sent to the grave for a little bit here. But no one turns up. Everyone's being a little bit scared. Brack's going to take the shotgun. He doesn't really mind too much. Pops a Scorched Earth just to get himself healed up again. Also got an Essence Ring if he wants to use it. I feel like Doom doesn't really have the mana pool to use Essence Ring now. I'm fairly sure that's just I guess if it keeps him alive, for a Doom.
He might. I mean, I really like this item because it gives you 6 intel, which is mana pool, and it gives you mana regen. So basically, like this item, not only that it gives you like mana, it also gives you health if you pop it.
Okay, he's going for a kill right now. He's looking for the Rubik, and they'll be able to bring him down with the help of 9. This is a aggression from JStorm, and successful aggression at that, and also securing themselves a bounty rune. Might just be one, but it's going to feel pretty good for them right now. Anything would feel good. I don't think JStorm are done, though. Brax is looking forward. They do have to be cautious. There's a shotgun down onto the low ground. Batrider taking some hits, but he's able to blast them away. But in goes the Morphling, but saved by the Snowball, at least for now. But what's going to happen when he comes out the other side? Well, I fear the worst. Meanwhile, Brax having to pop this BKB. Deflected Kid, no one, and Solo chasing up onto the high ground. Really want to finish off Fear, and they will be able to do so. They make him work for it, but he does go down. Moose also going to get finished off as well. 2 heroes dead on the side of JStorm. That's going to put an end to things. Moose, he wasn't really there. I mean, Moo wasn't really there. He was pushing out this top lane, just trying to make a little bit more space for himself and his team. I think that was the right call considering the situation.
Yeah. JStorm, they kind of need to doom the PL somehow. I feel like that's the only way to win the fight. Or Morphling, somehow. He doesn't have Aegis anymore, so if they manage to get a doom off on Morphling, it should be also really good.
Ugh, Mindbreaker.
And BKB as well on the morph.
Did he give the Mindbreaker to someone else?
PL.
Okay.
Well, Radiant have Repair Kit. That's actually really good for them.
Have you seen the new animations on it?
Yeah.
Oh, so nice.
It is. I like that it doesn't look like Treant armor anymore.
Yes, definitely. Especially when there's so many Treants in the game. It was fine when the patch first came out, no one was picking it, but.
Yeah.
Now it's a problem.
Radiant's top tower. What I don't like about the repair kit is that it doesn't make any sound or anything. So often what happens, for example, to me is that you use like 2 charges on the tower just because you don't like recognize when did you use it, because like no one really knows the range of it.
Yeah, that's
for
true.
Example. So, you know, that's a suggestion for Wolf. I'm sure they're watching right now, so...
No. Yeah, it's okay. I'm sure they'll be taking notes, don't worry. Also, if we could stop OD retroactively getting charges for his ultimate, that would be pretty sweet as well, because, you know, it's not very fun playing mid against OD when one suddenly just hits 6 and immediately presses R on you and you're like, oh, okay, cool.
Oh, does that work?
It did. I don't know if it still works, but it did work.
I mean, OD is just broken altogether.
It's He's hard. In a strange place.
Alright, Alk is... Alk already has AC, which is pretty good. He might not die instantly right now, even though...
Oh, Epileptic Kid, he's trying to find him. BKB, TP, get him out to safety. Didn't actually need to, as Epileptic Kid was guessing the wrong way, but I mean, you can't rely on that. He made the right call.
Yeah, he had Vesture anyways. I didn't even notice, but BKB wouldn't help with that. And it wouldn't help with Roar, so like the only hero which it would help is either Morph or Rubick.
So basically what you're saying is terrible BKB, what are you doing, mate?
Yeah, kind of that.
Titan Sliver picked up on VP. It's a decent item, especially for a Morphling.
When they have Telescope, that's also really good.
Yeah, it's a nice one. Now that it's an aura, giving no one even more reach. Really scary. Just jumping in right now. 9 trying to play a little bit of Dota, playing into Virtus Pro a bit. Did they use a repair kit? They haven't used it yet. Come on, Moose. Repair that boy. Curious.
I'm not sure if it was you with who I was saying it, but I called it that Telescope needs to go from tier 4 to tier 3, and they did it, and now it's a really good item. So, you know, when Valve listens to me,
good
things get good. Exactly.
Almost. He's playing a dangerous game right now, silenced up by that blade of his, but he is getting able to get the snowball off, trying to hold them together, but Doom's actually the one in trouble. Man, just get that BKB, they'll turn around the resolution and we'll be able to bring him down pretty quickly, and now, well, I mean, Epileptic Kid, he's still surviving inside the bomb doppelganger, trying to find onto Fear, but he's dropping so low just to 9 and Brax right now. They might be able to finish him off, Epileptic on the run. Meanwhile, Moore on the front lines is actually brought down by the rest of the team, and now they turn their attention towards the Doom. Doom just sitting there, will throw out the Doom. I think he dropped it onto, I'm not too sure who dropped it on, but Moon's going to get finished off as well. And well, the CM will not survive, but it's a very small price to pay as JStorm are picked off one by one. 4 heroes dead. Virtus Pro come flying down the middle lane. There's that repair kit coming out. The little scaffolding is down, but it's not enough to keep them out of the base. Virtus Pro coming in thick and fast. And now the lift up onto the Ember Spirit. He's a little bit too far forward and evaporated by no one. He is taken out of the game. And they're going to look forward for more. Tusk is going to be the target. A buyback comes out from Solo as well. He wants to be a part of this. They want to win the game right now as the boots of travel in from the Crystal Maiden, bringing them up towards the top lane as well. They are going for the Mega Creeps. 19 seconds left on that Alchemist. This death on the Ember Spirit has just opened up the entire game for Virtus Pro. JStorm, what can you do? Are there any options?
Oh no, he didn't repair to the tower.
Oh no. Well, maybe you're saving it for the tier 4. He's got 2 left, 2 towers left, but unfortunately no Batrider left. He's finished off immediately, and now Brax also in some trouble. Goes in with the stun, but the BKB from no one's going to keep him alive. Moon coming into the front lines, just flashing away, but no one is just as big, just as strong. He's got a stun, throws it over towards Moos, and that is going to get him that kill. Style points there for no one as they continue just bashing away onto Moo. Moo turns over towards the Phantom Lancer, but the Roar comes out onto him, and they can take him down again. That's an Alchemist dead. Doom's going to go down as well. The GG is called, and Virtus Pro just as quickly as game number 1, they are spinning in their favor and take game number 2 as well.
Whew. Yeah. It was kind of unfortunate that in the last fight before